are you going to go to? I mean, I assume you want to find some place to like set up a temporary base camp while you do stuff in the city. And then, so where do you want to go for that? And then what do you want to do after that?
I can't remember. Did we get a room at the hotel?
You have not yet. You could, yeah, that's an option. You go to the either the Traveler's Inn or the Holloway Hotel. The Holloway Hotel is more expensive.
Yeah.
It does have a like a parking garage type thing attached to it though. Because the Traveler's Inn has like a parking lot.
So we have a big boss ATV. That's what it's called.
Yep.
We have a big boss and a mountaineer ATV.
Okay.
If you're gonna mount the particle beam rifle on there, you can put with particle beam rifle mount. Just because that's not hard. You don't have like, you can very easily do that.
Yes.
Yes.
I was gonna say, are you modifying that or should I? I will add it on there. Whoop.
Okay, yeah, so the Traveler's Inn is 75 credits a night for staying there.
Okay.
For just like general accommodations, your average kind of shitty hotel room. The Holloway Hotel, which is much nicer, is 400 credits a night. And both of those include meals.
Well, I'm gonna go to the Holloway Hotel.
In all honesty, Will will probably just stay in the Mountaineer ATV.
Just stay in there.
Yeah. Then one, I can guard our vehicles.
Works,
I don't trust strange towns.
Yeah, that's fair. You have experience in people trying to steal your stuff. So.
Some actual rest and relaxation. Yeah.
Once we get some actual security systems and like cameras and stuff, then I'll leave them alone. But
So you're staying at the Holloway Hotel. We can deduct. Obviously, you can afford that with 59,000 credits. So you can deduct whatever it is after we figure out how many days you're going to be here. Yeah, so you want to add solar panels to the cars then, Lowell? In this
electric, we want to increase their range, right?
Because currently they're both battery powered.
Yeah.
Their range is in like a couple hundred miles, I think. Just 300 to 400 miles exit right now. But then, if you give it a solar panel, it's effectively infinite range. Unless there's no sun for some reason.
Brunhilda.
Unless the sun stops working, which is not out of the question. Okay, yeah, Big Boss is 300 mile range, and Mountaineer is 600 mile range. So pretty good, pretty long range, but not infinite.
Yeah, that's pretty much Willow's primary goal. That's probably what she'll be working on in the parking garage.
Sure. Yeah, so for that, you could probably do that with like £25 of components for each vehicle, just to give them a pretty like a little solar bank.
£25 of components?
Yeah.
Each?
For each one, yeah. Oh, by the way, did someone write down the location, the exact amount of stuff you got from the pile of loot?
No, I haven't updated that yet.
So it's 260 pounds of components and 308 pounds of metal. Assuming that you strip down and and
yeah
get rid of all the like trash.
Yeah, 260. Well, I guess 210 if you count
this. Yeah, if you're gonna use 50 of it.
That's a lot of components. Jesus. Yeah, I mean, we're gonna have to if we want to make these vehicles actually run with us. So yeah, so 210. So that'll be 214 components now. And then how much was the...
How much metal?
Yeah.
380.
Let's see. Nope, because you also have the 150 pounds of random usable metal on the bottom there. Wait, where did you see 380?
I think I
added... I see that. 1, 2, 3, 4... 450, so 480 it should be, I think.
Oh, yeah, I think I probably missed one of these 100 pound ones.
Yeah, so 480. Yeah,
480.
Okay. Making sure I'm not cheating here. Oop. There's the component.
Oh yeah, and you have the 655 gallon. I guess that's in zero right now. Mm-hmm. Right.
Yep.
So as long as you have that written down, like that it's in there.
I'm pretty sure it's in like on his inventory spot. But yeah, I remember.
Yeah. Okay. See,
where is it? Where's his stuff? I have no idea. There he is.
And I think we sold like all the rest of the guns then, didn't we?
I think you sold all of them except for Rudge took the ion pistol.
Yep, I wrote that down on my inventory, yeah, and I do have the 655 gallon barrels of accelerant.
Okay. Just to clarify, it's a heavy duty ion blaster, right?
Yep. And G57.
Yeah. Okay.
I got a 2d4, 3d6. I'm assuming that's mega damage.
Yep.
Yeah, it's also on Discord there. The full stats are in case you miss it.
That's where I got it from, yeah, I'm assuming. Because I don't know where to find that shit.
Yeah.
It took me forever to find, like, gear in that Ultimate book.
Yeah, no, it's because some fucking idiot decided page 270 is a good page to start fucking items on.
It's pretty spread out, too.
Yeah, it's not in the same area.
The first thing I found for, like, idea of gear, like, I wanted to build was, like, cybernetic upgrades. I'm like, well, this is a good place to start.
No, that's in a different place, of course. Why would that be in the same place? That's in the middle of the character creation section.
Mm-hmm. If you do get cybernetics, that actually takes away from your superpowers.
Yeah, no, I don't want to put them in. That's just stuff that I would want to, like ideas of shit I'd want to buy. Or not buy, but make, create, either make or get.
Okay.
Like a molecular analyzer, a radio receiver and transmitter, a climbing cord.
Not for me.
I can
fly. Cybernetic versions of them. Yeah,
exactly. Just shit to put into my suit.
Yep.
Makes sense. Okay. So then I think that should be all the loot that you got divided out.
Yeah.
So then, Willow, you want to give me a mechanical engineer role, probably? Unless there's something more relevant to building solar panels you have.
No, I mean, that probably makes the most sense.
It's probably a solar panel role build skill,
I mean,
because that's
probably
what it gets.
This is...
Alternative energies, that's what it's called.
Yeah, sustainable energy systems skill.
And there's probably like a subtable between solar and...
Oh my god.
And it's like, oh, well, I get a plus 8.5% of geothermal, but...
Yes, that's a very, very good success.
I can build the shit out of a windmill, but I can't build a water mill. Why not?
39, I needed a 60-something. So, success.
Okay, yeah, so... It will take you about a week of work to strip down all of the loot you got and build the solar panels by just like working the metal.
Yep.
And components, but you can do that. And so that would take up like probably 75% of your time in that.
Yeah, that's fine.
In that amount. So if you have any other like minor things you want to do in that time, you can try and do those.
I feel like if anything, she'd just be probably working more on blueprints because I'm sure she's planning stuff.
Yeah, just like general.
Yeah, she has a lot of things like coming up in terms of plans, so she's probably spending any and all free time drawing up schematics in her head.
And Rudge, it's 2,800 credits for staying at the Holloway Hotel for a week.
Alright.
But it's pretty nice. Like, it's definitely the nicest place you've stayed, here.
Yeah.
You know, on this planet. It's got, like, a pretty soft bed. There's a thermostat, that does work, but it doesn't go that far down. It's maybe enough that you can, like... No, not really. Your like, maximum survivable temperature is, like, 30 degrees, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so it can't really go far enough down to make you comfortable, but it's cooler than outside.
Yep.
And, yeah, the food is... fairly nice human food, a lot of like beef and bread and stuff. Pretty basic, but
any veggies and stuff?
Yeah, there are some veggies. Yeah, right, you're a vegetarian.
I mean, you know, I'll eat what I have to survive.
If you need to, but you prefer veggies.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, there's bread and some like corn and stuff.
I'll make
the occasional bit of lettuce.
I'll make some sort of bread bowl with like soups and
corn and whatnot. Some tomatoes.
Yep.
It seems like most of the people around here eat meat.
Mm-hmm.
So that's a lot of the
that's fine.
Protein around. But.
Did I eat some kind of giant insect on the street?
Yeah, you ate a giant insect down in the downtown market.
That's the street.
Like a fried insect.
Yeah, good stuff.
Is there anything in particular that Rudge wants to do during this week?
You
guys stink.
I mean, it would be work on those, like, mapping drones.
Okay. Work on the design of them, or...
I suppose. Yeah, did you ever see that little video I showed you?
Yeah.
Yeah, I just basically want to make that.
Do you have, like, any skills relevant to that? Like, you have AI programming?
Yes.
You could... I would say you could try and do that to, like, figure out the, like, pathing that they would need to use.
Okay. So, I have a 76 in that.
Alright, yeah. Give it a roll.
Alright. Come on with it.
Pretty good.
Yeah, and of course I get a 90.
Of course. Alright, yeah, so you're working on it, but you haven't really figured out the...
Yeah.
It's not your main specialty, so...
Yeah, so as soon as I could, after a couple days of not getting it, I'd go to Willow and ask for help. Like, whenever, you know...
Girl has zero AI skills, so she isn't really...
Gotcha.
Yeah, she can build the frame. She could build one hell of a frame.
Okay, I see.
She could build the actual...
That's what we were talking about. Because like, we were saying together we could make an army of robots.
Yep.
Yeah.
And I'm like, where do I come in? It sounds like you can do everything. That's where I come in. The brains in the bots.
She'll design some scary ass looking robots, but they're just gonna stand there.
Right. you can make some Iron Man 2s.
Yeah.
Basically.
They salute.
Yeah, so if you figure that out, making just like a little sphere that flies around with like some sensors on it would probably be pretty easy for Willow.
Yep. Alright, so I guess let me know when I can roll again, but that's what I'll be doing.
Sure. I mean, if you guys want to spend another week hanging out here, you could try and roll again.
Not for 2,800. Like, then I'd jump to the lower end or stay in the vehicles.
Yeah, you probably like come back to the Mountaineer ATV and there's just fucking mechanical parts everywhere. Yeah,
just all over like, the inside.
Like, for some reason, it's like all on your bed, too.
It's alright, it's not hard to move. Like, I see you've been busy.
Yes, we need to mount these solar panels as soon as possible, too, so that way we can extend the range, so we don't have to pay for energy, too, because that'd be a waste.
Couldn't you have figured out another way to recharge the battery? Or is this going to recharge the battery?
Well, I mean, these are solar panels. These will keep the batteries charged forever, as long as there's sunlight.
True. So that's what I mean there. They're also charging the batteries, or are they just straight up powering the rigs?
Yes, they'll be powering the batteries as well.
Alright, hooray!
So it'll be a solar panel and inverter, basically.
Yes. Well, kudos. Good job. I highly approve.
Yes, then. Provided we can get back to our base, I can actually probably modify them to recharge our E-packs, too, on our weapons, so...
That's a little awesome. Charging terminal inside of the,
Yep, so we don't have to pay for that bullshit.
Mm-hmm. I mean, just run out in the middle of the wilderness and be like, well...
Well, it doesn't even consider that, because her gun rig recharges, like, with her backpack, so she's like...
Yeah, you got the solar backpack.
Yep.
So, what do we want to do? Hang out here more? And I don't know.
I mean, as soon as these solar panels are done, I have no reason to hang around here, except for we could potentially try and track down some machinery to bring back to the base so we could set up some manufacturing stuff. Because now that we do have some materials, we could potentially begin processing, getting some fabrication going, training people to use machines. I don't know. Well, I mean, I imagine if we talk to one of the outfitters here, maybe they actually have some suppliers in town that actually build the stuff here. I don't know too much about manufacturing on this planet, so we're probably just going to have to start somewhere and ask questions. I mean, we could try talking to the Holloway, like, armory and outfitters, because that's where we got the other stuff from, right? Or which guy did we sell stuff to?
You sold stuff to Bandito Arms guy, but...
Yeah, I mean, we could just go talk to him. Oh,
I mean, yeah, you could go talk to him. You know that he doesn't have anything like that.
Yeah.
Because they manufacture out of city, but, I mean, he might know something.
Yeah, I mean, that's probably our best place to stop.
You have an established rapport with Dwight there.
Yep. Yeah, so we could either go talk to him and just ask questions about where we might find something like that, or we could just wander around and look ourselves. Though I feel like with our... With our unique looks, we might have drawn some attention by collapsing a building. So I feel like one. I mean, you look very unique, and I look very unique in this area.
I thought this was that melting pot of crazies.
Yeah, but I feel like, you know, there were cops.
They're both wearing, like, pristine, like, ultra high tech, like, white and blue armor.
It just means we're rich.
Yeah, but that probably stands out. That's probably something that, like, if there was one detail about that house being collapsed, it's probably us. Bah. They're like, a bunch of crackheads are fighting some super robots or something. And here's what they looked like.
I gave those crackheads weapons. They won't bother anyone.
You realize that they're crackheads. They're probably just going to shoot you with the weapons you gave them.
No, I'm saying, like, as in just to not worry about the house. Like, those weapons were worth way more in that crack house.
Oh, yeah, but no, I'm sorry. I was more referring to the fact that we killed a bunch of people and that they'll probably want to kill us back.
That was like a gang, wasn't it? Or was it just random crack hoes?
It was a gang.
The house that you destroyed?
Yeah.
But no, I'm talking about, like, we were killing people in that process.
Oh, yeah, the skeevers.
And wasn't that the gang we wiped out?
No, the crack house was just collateral damage from...
No, he's talking about in the sewer.
Oh, yeah, that's the gang that you attacked. I mean, some of them escaped, but...
I think they're just gonna go, you know, to the... whoever's left. Like, they're gonna go, hey, our gang's dead, let us join yours, whoever's left. kind of thing.
You're very optimistic. I like your attitude.
All right. Fine. They're not going to come after us. We destroyed them utterly. They'd be fools to to mess with us again.
Yeah, but unless they go tell somebody about, hey, so-and-so wiped out this gang single-handedly, basically. And they're like, oh, shit, we better take them out.
Or they'd be like, I don't think we should mess with them anymore because they wiped out a gang single-handedly.
Just, again, you're very optimistic. I like that attitude.
Let's mug him. Wait.
I feel like we've popped rolls here.
Yeah. He took out the dragon of Karazar. Alright, so. I don't mind hanging around here, honestly. I'm not fearful of the locals.
Alright,
so, spend a little bit more time here. Are you gonna stay at the hotel, or are you gonna go sleep in your back of your car?
I'll sleep in the car.
Okay, so yeah, that's not really a problem. Every once in a while, you will get like yelled at by someone to like move because you're parked in a place where apparently you're not allowed to park for like X amount of time. But yeah, I mean, you just do that and. It's not really a big deal. You just drift around from like roadside parking lot to
find a Walmart parking lot to sleep in.
Yeah, exactly.
I would even if it became like a frequent of a thing, I would just go to the racing guy and ask him if we could just park out back or something, like behind his garage.
Yeah, he'd probably just be like, he'd just kind of shrug and say, yeah, a couple days, sure.
Cool. We're just working on...
Don't get in the way.
Nah, we're working on a few things before we head out.
Alright, yeah. I mean, you bought 2 cars from us, so...
And I gave you a pretty good show, too.
That you did. Had quite a few people ask about that.
Yeah, now you can even guarantee 100-foot drops.
That's right. Too bad I didn't get it on film.
Oh, I got that.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm. It'll cost you.
Well,
It'll cost you 2 nights of letting us chill behind your garage.
Ah, sure, yeah. That's a deal.
Perfect. I'll go and make a copy.
All right.
I don't know how if I can put it on a format for Earth.
Yeah, so the thing is, like, your video format type, file type, is probably different than theirs, but
Could I do a projection, and then he can tape that?
Like, yeah, you could probably figure out some way of doing it.
We got some bootleg DVDs.
Yeah, it would probably be something related to that, honestly.
Well, there's somebody, like, sitting in the front seat, standing up the whole time.
Like, you go to, like, transfer the file to his, like, little... computer or whatever, and the like his USB cable is just totally different than yours. It's like,
You fucking iPhone.
Damn, you need an adapter for this.
I have computer programming.
Yeah, so do I.
Yeah, no, I said do you, because if you do, you can change the format on stuff with that skill, I think.
Okay, I
think that's the purpose of it, but I think technically, because it's alien.
Would be a good thing to.
I mean, the thing operations. Is. No, that's different.
That's what I have.
That's doing the bootleg thing.
Gotcha. Yeah, So we're doing the bootleg
thing. Alright, I know how to use computers, so I'm just gonna take,
The best part of this is I'm good at it too, so we can work together and I can assist you holding up, a white screen or something.
Mm-hmm. Yep, so you succeed in, converting, in quotes, your video to give to this guy.
Cool.
They're totally fine with you staying in the back. That's for sure. Alright, so probably going to be doing some other stuff, but in the meantime, are you guys going to go to the Bandito Arms place and ask Dwight about manufacturing stuff?
Yeah, I think that's probably the best way to start.
Sure.
I mean, I guess we could just ask the race guys, too.
You could ask them, too, yeah.
In passing, like, we'll...
Sure.
While we're fucking with the video. Hey, you happen to know any where to get some manufacturing parts? looking to set up some sort of self-sustaining operation out in the wilderness.
Kind of like
all like manufacturing equipment.
Scratches his head and says, well, I mean, the got Bandito and Wilkes, they import mostly what I know. The others, they're the main weapons and armor suppliers. I guess there's Holloway's people down the road there. That's probably your best bet. I don't know if they sell that stuff, but I know they have it. They know they have it.
Yeah, so they know where it comes from, at least.
Yeah, it's probably your best bet. Maybe start at the outfitters, and if that doesn't work, ask the at the tower or the police or something.
All right.
Might need some rep or something to get talking to a big guy, but you know how it is.
Yeah.
Just if you do somehow end up talking to Holloway, watch out, he's got a bit of a temper from what I hear.
Oh, fun. That's all right. I can't remember. Oh, no, never mind. I thought like one of us was good at dealing with psychos. But that's a zombie game.
That's me.
Yep, exactly.
Good at dealing with psychos. Well. So, who are we going to talk to?
He said either the gun guy or the fucking Holloway guys or the police guys. Just a bunch of guys.
Yeah, the outfitters or Holloway Tower or the police. All associated with this guy who you assume is named Holloway, mm-hmm. who's in charge, given the amount of things that have his name plastered across them in this area. Yeah.
So the El Paso police work for Holloway, or is it like a mutual respect kind of thing?
They work for him.
Oh. Okay.
He's the
El Presidente?
Yeah. I don't know what his official title is. I think it's governor.
Yeah.
It might be. No, it's king.
Okay, I was gonna say, let's go with governor from Walking Dead.
Yeah, no, it's King Wyattella.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, I guess we could go try and talk to him and see, you know, if they kick us out, then we could figure it out from there. But, I mean, if we ask a question, they kick us out, then we come back a week later with a bunch of reputation.
Yeah.
All right, sure. At what point during your second week of hanging out here do you want to go and try and talk there?
Let's see. How long did it take for me to get the solar panels on?
Once you make them, it may be, like, a day or two, at most.
And how long do you say they take to make?
A week. So you've made them at this point.
Yeah, I mean, if I've made them, I'd probably get them fully installed first. Once they're fully installed, then I'm all down for going on a wild goose chase.
All right. Sure.
And I'll work on my drone while she's putting them on.
Okay. Yeah. Give me a roll. Another roll.
Come on, baby. Don't do it again. Don't 90 me. All right, 51.
51.
Yeah. Yep.
Out of. Okay. So you're probably not finished by the time Willow is done with outfitting the solar panels, but you feel like you're making progress, and you've got a good start. Couple more days and you could probably get something figured out for it.
Alright, I'll finish it when we get back from our little adventure. Or not adventure, but our
attempted
yes.
talk.
our networking.
All right. What time of day do you want to head over there?
11.
1:11?
Yep.
1:11 p.m. or a.m.?
Yep, p.m.
Just the middle of the night.
I mean, I could see us doing that accidentally. Yep.
All right, we just finished some work. Fuck, I'm still awake. Want to go fucking do that? Yeah.
I mean, in all honesty, he might be the type to be up super late, so it's not actually a bad idea, potentially.
Okay, hold on. All right, no, we're going at 1:11 p.m. I rolled for it.
All right. Let me take a quick nap.
So you, by the way, while you guys are moving, neither of you have drive skills, right?
No.
Okay, so you're driving one of them. Why don't you just both give me drive rolls untrained?
What is that? As good as your IQ?
Yep.
Awesome.
Just to see, you know, with your general driving of around places in the city.
83. Really?
Okay.
Yeah.
Wow, I got 83. Yeah, that's amazing.
So you don't get into any like
car accidents.
Yeah, you don't get into any like serious car accidents, but you do like do some very obnoxious like dumb stuff in traffic, and you get honked at a lot.
Oh yeah,
you yelled at, and you generally just driving like drunk grandmas.
The best kind of grandmas.
Like road beer and all.
Yeah. Yep.
All right. So.
But yeah, I just wanted to see if any of you like did really really bad.
Yep. I immediately take a note that I need to make a driving AI.
Yeah, that's probably a good idea.
Willow doesn't notice she did bad.
Yep.
It's fine. Like, goal achieved.
I've seen bad drivers on my planet. This is that. Like, oh, this is a ridiculous contraption. I can't believe this is what they use as modes of transportation.
Yeah, you can't, like, pivot
yeah.
while you're just, like, stationary because of the wheels. It's very ridiculous. Yeah.
Like, I understand the physics and everything, you know, the wheels. But it's just, no, gyroscopes and hover things is the way to go. Yes. Hover engine, yeah. Damn it.
Alright, so you guys head over to Holloway Tower at around 1:11 p.m.
I watch Willow and she's doing exactly as bad as me.
Yeah, I feel like that's the problem. Is like I'm like, oh, I trust Rudge with driving, so we got this. And I followed your exact movements. And like, but I fucked up even more. So like when you took a weird sharp left turn in the middle of the road, I went right.
Yeah.
You so just like sprayed out across all four lanes of traffic.
We're fucking up everywhere, not just a little bit. We're cutting a big swath.
Yep.
We get there. Holy shit, we're terrible at this. You especially, but me also especially.
Yep.
Maybe we should hire drivers or no? I'm gonna work on an AI. That's what I'm gonna do. Anyway, we're here.
Alright.
And I don't think we killed anyone.
I mean, the Mountaineer's big enough, I don't think you'd feel it if you ran someone over, so...
No, but that's why I said I don't think. I didn't see any blood smears. I guess check the tires?
I was looking at all the camera footage and stuff after just to make sure.
Zero. I'd be like, no, sir, you didn't kill anyone.
Yeah, so, you guys walk up the, like, the stairs. This is, like, a big sort of skyscraper-esque building. Think, like...
Tenpenny Tower?
Yeah. Ooh, kind
yeah.
of.
Yeah.
Like, sort of sleek, modern skyscraper just sitting amidst an apocalyptic... semi-apocalyptic city. And there's some, like, stairs going up to the front door with a pair of El Paso police standing guard out side. If you don't approach them, they don't bother you. They just kind of stare at you.
Okay.
But there is like automatic doors as you walk into the front lobby area. And there's a handful of more police and a couple of other people just kind of walking around. the like front desk, which is right in front of what seems to be like an elevator door. There's a man in what you assume is like nice clothing sitting there, talking to a guy who's kind of leaning on the counter with a like a pair of sort of like very skeletal looking cybernetic legs and a matching arm missing one of his other arms.
Oh.
I just like the what you assume is fancy clothes.
Yeah. You guys have no idea. You haven't seen anyone with fancy clothes.
I'm wearing fancy clothes under my armor.
Freak show. Well, that's your kind of fancy clothes.
I know, but that's what I mean. That's the only comparison I have. Is it exactly. Kind of like that?
It's he's wearing like a sort of a nice looking sort of coat.
Ooh.
With a coat. Like a bow tie type thing.
A bow tie. This is insane. All right, let's talk to this crazy person.
So you guys step up to the counter. The man sitting behind it, they stop their conversation. He kind of looks over and raises an eyebrow a little bit as he studies you and says, I'm sorry, you don't look familiar. Can I help you? And before you have a chance to say anything, the guy with the skeleton limbs that he's talking to kind of turns around and looks at you and says, look who it is.
Yes. And, who do I recognize this guy?
It takes you a half second, but it's John Willoughby, your rescue person.
Yeah.
Okay. It takes a little bit just because he seems more like in one piece now, and yep. you know, you only really saw him when he was dissected.
Yep.
But he seems to have eyes again.
Oh,
and,
shit.
Hey. Definitely healing and in the process of getting limbs back, but
good to see you on your feet.
Yep, new feet. Not as nice as the old ones, but whatever.
No, I suppose not.
I got some more works. And the front desk guy kind of looks and says, you know these people, Mr. Willoughby? Yeah. Yeah, this big fella, he pulled me out of a pretty nasty situation. When I was telling you about, lost me my gear. And man nods and says, well, that's quite noble of them.
Well, we didn't do it for free, but noble.
Rudge, did you take all the credit for doing this?
I said we. Just now. I wasn't going to
interrupt
them.
Willoughby kind of looks over again and says, I assume that you part of it as well. Haven't had the chance to meet while I'm here. So, nice to meet you, I guess, whatever your name is.
This is my companion, Willow. Believe me, neither of us would be standing here if not for her.
Well, then, thanks, Willow. And
happy to assist.
Front desk guy kind of says, "Well, that's all well and good, but what are you doing here? This is technically a public space, but the only reason to come here is if you have an appointment in the tower. And I don't believe I have any willows in my book." He says, like glancing down at his little like notepad thing.
Well,
like looks over, like trying to like see what if there's any actual writing on there.
He like pulls it back, and kind of gives you a stern look.
So out of game, what kind of manufacturing stuff are you looking for? Stuff to make weapons, stuff to make machinery, stuff.
I mean, all honestly, probably like general fabrication is probably the best thing to start with. Because if we do, if we can get fabrication, we can realistically use that for anything. It just takes time to convert it.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Okay. And what are the and the Halloway's? Or is this the tower of the Halloway? Like.
Yes, it's Halloway Tower.
Halloway Tower. Okay.
It's like the Capitol building of the city.
Okay.
Courthouse, all the like vital government functions.
Mm-hmm. Okay. We are a couple of Well, we have a fledgling settlement we are working with and trying to flourish. So we are in need of quite a few things. One of them being manufacturing fabrications. And we have been told that around town, Halloway is the best and only name to see for such things. We wonder if you could point us in a direction of the right people to speak to.
You're looking to purchase equipment?
Yes.
Hmm. Well, generally we don't sell to random passerby.
Hmm. I suppose we are passing by. We are not so random.
Well, that's actually not quite true, Rudge. We actually are looking to eventually establish a trade route to here as well, but we wanted to get our manufacturing up before we attempted to offer any form of trade. Because as of now, we don't have much to offer in the way of trade, but soon enough we could.
I see, and who are you exactly?
Willow, remember?
Yes. Rudge Valzena.
Okay. He seems to be, like, taking businesses. And your settlement, how large is it?
It's quite small currently.
I throw in a number of, like, what do they use here? Kilometers?
Miles.
I say what it is-ish.
We have a couple dozen hardy frontier folk working hard for us.
I pretty much go from the tree line to the lake as ours.
Oh right, yeah, your claimed territory.
Yeah.
All right. So he looks kind of skeptical and says, "Oh, it's awfully small," and
tense.
Willoughby kind of reaches out his one arm and, like, smacks him on the shoulder, like, come on, Jives. These guys saved my life. Give them a shot.
Yes, give us this shot.
Yes, we can prove
it. You can tell the boss man that I vouch for him.
This seems to be a place where they respect a show of skill, so test us. We would happily show our worth.
Well, very well, let me make some calls. And he gets on like a, you know, in-building communication system and talks a little bit. He kind of like moves away from the front of the desk and is talking fairly quietly. You can still hear him, Willow, because of your enhanced hearing. But he's pretty much just seems to be telling multiple people you're like general, just reiterating the information that you told them and saying what you want. And the whole process takes like probably about 10 minutes. You guys just sitting up there at the counter.
I'd be talking
with Willoughby. We'll just gonna stare at them the entire time.
I would talk to Willoughby.
Alright, just like...
I'd be like, so how do you know these guys? Seems you have some influence here.
I've done work with Halloway. helped him a lot get to where he is.
Oh, like the Holloway? You know, the man at
top? Yeah. He's a bastard.
Most men in charge are.
Exactly, they're all bastards there. I had done work for him in the past. Enough that he's willing to get me a room at his fancy hotel until I off myself or somebody else does.
Off yourself? Why would you do such a thing?
He just kind of like gestures around and says, I mean, look at this place. I don't mean here exactly, just the world in general. It's shit.
It is quite a rough one. But not the hardest one I've seen, but it's definitely not the easiest.
Yeah, I'm afraid all that's left for me is a couple years drinking and meeting other comforts before I take my long and treacherous trip down to hell.
Almost poetic.
Yep.
Well, I don't know if how long you've thought about this, and it sounds like a decision that doesn't come easy to make, that this is the life you're going to lead, but...
Not really something you really decide in one moment. It's just kind of where you find yourself once you get...
Well, as I don't know
tired of it.
I don't know if you would be interested in changing it up some, but as we said, we are making an establishment and could use someone of your caliber around. Not so much, it would get you out of the bloody work and more a protecting role, plus it'd be simpler life. We have fairly good mechanics, could keep you in top shape all the time. And I recently read up on cybernetics. I believe any repairs you would need, I could handle. So,
give me a trust intimidate roll at plus 40%.
Okay. So. Right. Do I have? Nope, I don't. So is it IQ then plus the 40?
Yep.
Okay. 67. So I have 63.
Oh, not so pretty close, but not quite.